Travel bans, face masks, and fear. We connect you through the latest as the novel coronavirus spreads to nearly a quarter of the world. The number of new cases reported outside of mainland China is now greater than inside. The World Health Organization today warning this virus still has the potential to erupt into a global pandemic. Have a listen.
What's happening in the rest of the world? That's now our greatest concern. We're at a decisive point.
Well, let's get you the latest numbers. More than 82,000 cases and 2,800 deaths. Some of the most troubling news today coming from South Korea. More than 500 new cases there reported over the past day. And there is growing concern about two other major hotspots for this virus, Iran and Italy. Iranian media today reporting the vice president of Women and Family Affairs has tested positive. She was seen sitting close to Iran's president just yesterday during a cabinet meeting. And in Italy, the epicenter of the outbreak in Europe, the number of reported cases jumped by more than 30% in a day, now topping 500. The health minister defending the country's handling of the virus. And we're going to hear from Italy's deputy health minister in just a moment. First, let me bring in the CNN team on this. Jamana Karadze tracking developments out of Iran. Ivan Watson is in Seoul for you. And Claire Sebastian is in New York watching the stock market, Wall Street, enduring its worst week since the 2008 financial crisis. I'll come to you in a moment, Claire. Jamana, first, we've seen a huge jump in the number of cases in Iran, the death toll now at 26, with the number of infections nearly doubling, including another cabinet minister. How concerned should people be?
Well, you know, Becky, I think people should be concerned. And the one issue here is that we don't really know the extent of the outbreak in Iran. We just don't know how bad the situation really is. And the reason for that is that, the information we're getting, the figures that we're getting are coming from the government. This is a country where information is very tightly controlled. And if you look at the figures, if you look at the mortality rate from coronavirus at this point, it's somewhere around 10%. That is significantly higher than any other country in the world, than the global average mortality rate. And there's lots of questions about that and why that is. It's inconsistent with what we are seeing, the trend globally. And one theory here is that possibly there's underreporting in the number of confirmed cases. We don't know why. Is it an issue with screening, medical capabilities in the country? Are people not going to hospitals and reporting this? And, is this a case where we're seeing the Iranian government basically controlling the information and not being very transparent about what is going on? And we've heard from people in Iran, some, taking the risk of speaking out on social media. And CNN has also been able to speak to some people inside the country anonymously who wanted to also share their concerns about what is going on. And some say that their government doesn't seem to be taking the situation seriously, that it's not doing enough. But the Iranian government is saying the situation is under control. They say they've put measures in place. Even that extraordinary move of, not holding Friday prayers in the cities where there has been a confirmed outbreak. But still, some are questioning their decision at this point not to quarantine any of the cities where there's been an outbreak, Becky.
That's a story in Iran, and of course the concerns across the Middle East and Gulf region is that this thing could spread significantly, and we are seeing incidents of those who have travelled through Iran now getting ill in other places. Ivan, the number of cases in South Korea increasing significantly, announcing 500 new cases today. What are authorities doing and saying there?
Well, one dramatic move is that the military alliance here, Becky, that's the U.S. and South Korea, the commanders have just announced that they're postponing joint military exercises indefinitely. And that probably is due to the fact that the Korean Defense Ministry says it has nearly 10,000 Korean military personnel in quarantine, and they've already found some 25 cases of coronavirus across all four branches of the South Korean military. The U.S. military here in Korea, and recall there's around 30,000 troops stationed here, have confirmed a third case linked to one of the U.S. bases here. In this case, it's a South Korean employee attached to Camp Carroll. That is a base near the southern city of Daegu, where roughly half of South Korea's coronavirus cases have been diagnosed. That's the third case on yesterday. There was a 23-year-old American soldier who was attached to that same base who tested positive for coronavirus and then was put into isolation for treatment. So clearly a big concern for both militaries, and clearly concerned that if they conduct joint military exercises, it could let the virus spread further. Meanwhile, as you mentioned, more than 500 new cases in a period of about 24 hours. And unfortunately, about 13 people have lost their lives here in South Korea as a result of coronavirus. That city Daegu, which is kind of the epicenter of South Korea's outbreak, we haven't seen any signs of panic there. However, we've been talking to some residents there, including this English teacher from the U.S., who is determined to stay in that city and weather out this public health crisis. Take a listen.
There's just fewer people out on the streets. Everyone's, for the most part, taking the self-quarantine advice very seriously. I went out myself today because I had to pay a bill at the bank, but I was wearing gloves. Everyone's wearing masks. It's just life is normal, except the streets are sparsely populated. I live near a couple markets, and those are still open. The convenience stores are still open.
Now, the authorities say that they're moving some of the patients from Daegu to hospitals here in Seoul to help accommodate just the sheer rush of people who are seeking treatment now.